नमस्ते स्टूडेंट, मैं सिर्फ डॉक्टर कुंदन मिश्रम, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अगरतंत्र एवं विधि विद्यालय, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मेटल टॉक्सिसिटी इन लास्ट फ्यू लेक्चर. टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मेटल टॉक्सिसिटी एंड आयरन टॉक्सिसिटी. हियर व्हाट इज iron. Iron is a lustrous, ductile, malleable, silvery gray metal which dissolves radially in the dilute acids. It chemically active and forms two major series of chemical compounds. That is bivalent iron, which is also called as ferrous compounds, and trivalent iron, which is also called as a ferric compound. Childhood exposure to the pediatric multivitamin tablets, which rarely leads to the serious toxicity after the ingestion. Adult preparations such as iron pills or prenatal vitamins with iron, which are responsible for almost all of the serious toxicity related iron poisoning. Then iron has ability to produce oxygen free radical under the aerobic condition, which turns it into the potential harmful component. Free radicals are generated within the cell as the part of normal cellular mechanism. However, the overproduction of reactive oxygen species such as superoxide and hydroxyl radicals may lead to the cellular damage. The resulting effects are impaired synthesis of proteins, membranes, lipids, and carbohydrates, induction of protease, and altered cell proliferation. Then, in the disease of iron overload, the generation of free radicals leads to the tissue damage and organ failure. Excess of free iron has been considered as the carcinogenic. Once the generation of free radical by the metal can be promoted at DNA strand break, oncogenic activation, and tumor suppressor and gene inhibition. The role of iron in the neurodegenerative disorder such as the Parkinsonism and Alzheimer's disease suggested to be the iron overload increases the brain oxidative stress status. Since no mechanism exists for excreting iron, toxicity depends on the amount of iron already in the body. The toxicity level in the intravenous administration are more than the intramuscular and oral administration of the iron. Then, stages of acute iron toxicity. It includes the five stages of the acute iron toxicity. That is stage 1, local gastrointestinal effect. Stage 2, quiescent phase. Stage 3, a systemic toxicity. Stage 4 are recovery phase, and stage 5 are gastrointestinal obstruction. In stage 1, that is the gastrointestinal toxicity, the symptoms of nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea are found. The gastrointestinal bleeding may lead to hematemesis or bloody diarrhea. It attributes to the direct local corrosive effect of the iron. It occurs early, usually within the several hours. The pathologic effects are concentrated in the stomach, duodenum, area of small bowel infection can be observed distally, and colon is rarely affected. These initial local corrosive changes sometimes lead to the formation of gastric, enteral, and pyloric structure, which are observed in some patients between 2 and 8 weeks after the initial episode of the poisoning. Then the stage 2, quiescent phase, where the resolution of gastrointestinal symptoms with the apparent clinical improvement. Some studies show that the patient has a resolution of the gastrointestinal symptoms and become critically ill after 24 hours and died. Then stage 3, which includes systemic toxicity. Clinically, it manifests as the shock with associated with signs of the hypoperfusion, that is pallor, cold extremities, tachycardia, tachypnea, hypotension. Then the hypovolemic shock and acidosis are the primary determinants of this shock state, but the diminished cardiac functions contribute. Hypovolemic shock results from the gastrointestinal fluid losses as well as the increased capillary permeability and possible loss of the venous tone. Mitochondrial dysfunction may be seen in the severe iron poisoning. Heart failure is the frequent seen in the chronic iron poisoning due to the overload of the free iron induced damage. Hepatic injuries. It includes portal blood deliver high concentration of the iron to the liver. It is ferritin. Range from the cloudy, swelling to Periportal hepatic necrosis and elevated transaminases are observed. Iron is concentrated within the hepatic mitochondria where it destroys mitochondrial membranes. Hepatic necrosis and metabolic acidosis are seen in the first poison. Abnormalities in the coagulation and inhibitory effect on the clotting factors are also seen in such poison. Then a stage 4, that is the clinical recovery phase. It begins soon after the initiation of the fluid and antidotal therapy. For severely poisoned patients, recovery will be marked by the resolution of the acidosis and other signs of the shock. It usually within 3 to 4 days of the acute poisoning, and full recovery may take longer duration. Then stage 5, gastrointestinal obstruction. Here the late onset of the gastric and pyloric stricture, which may occur 2 to 8 weeks after the initial injury. These strictures appear in the mucosa in which there was previous damage and they frequently require surgical therapy. Then diagnosis of the iron poisoning. The testing serum iron concentration is the best method to confirm the iron poisoning. Repeat the serum iron test for 4 to 6 hours after the initial measurement. Total iron binding capacity also be measured to the diagnosis of the iron poisoning. And the and abdominal radiographic examination can be useful to identify the metallic object. Then laboratory testing should be include serum, electrolyte, blood, urea, nitrogen, and glucose. Alanine and aspartate aminotransferase and bilirubin level should be calculated in the laboratory. Venous and arterial blood gases in the moderately and severely poisoned patients should be found out. Complete blood count and differential blood count should be found out. Also, the prothrombin and partial thromboplastin time should be tested in the laboratory. Then, peak serum iron concentration typically correlate with the following level of the toxicity. When there is the concentration less than 350 microgram per dL, it leads to the minimal toxicity. While if the concentration between 350 to 500 microgram per dL to the mild to the moderate gastrointestinal symptoms, which rarely develop the serious complications. Greater than 500 microgram per dL concentration leads to the serious systemic toxicities, and the concentration more than 1000 microgram per dL leads to the significant morbidity and mortality. The toxicity may not be related to the dose. The ideal serum iron level is the peak level drawn between 2 and 6 hours after the injection. Then differential diagnosis. The other agent that can cause vomiting with the toxic injection include salicylate, caustic agent, theophylline, isopropanol, arsenic, and the mercuric salt, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is NSAIDs, organophosphorus compounds, nicotine, carbamates, mushrooms, and colchicine also shows the same effects like the iron poisoning, which can be differential diagnosed from the iron poisoning. Then clinical management. Clinical evaluation is the important criteria for such poisoning for the management. Here the fluid resuscitation, which establishes intravenous excision and administration normal saline at the initial dose of 20 ml per kg, followed by continuous infusion. Also the laboratory evaluation and abdominal radiograph for the clinical management is useful. Then chelation therapy. The criteria for initiation of therapy include the history of iron injection with any clinical signs of the shock, lethargy, coma, and altered mental status, permanent percentage vomiting, diarrhea, hematemesis, hematochezia, or other gastrointestinal symptoms. Then positive anion gap, metabolic acidosis, large number of pills on the abdominal radiograph, serum iron level greater than 500 microgram per dL, and estimated dose greater than 60 mg of iron per kg. Desferoxime is 15 mg per kg per hour as the continuous intravenous infusion. Can be given at the dose of 90 mg per kg intramuscularly if IV access is not feasible. The chelation therapies will be continuous until there is a significant resolution of systemic toxicity, especially acidosis and shock. This therapeutic side effect. This serotonin side effects include hypotension, acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS, gastrointestinal discontinuations. Any patient with probable or confirmed significant exposure should have cold bowel irritation. Polyethylene glycol electrolyte solution at the rate of 0.5 liter per hour for the children or 2 liter per hour for adults. Its side effects are nausea, bloating, vomiting, and diarrhea. The whole bowel irrigation is continued until the effluent is clear. Magnesium hydroxide might be used to reduce the absorption. Patients with no history of abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea, and with the normal physical examination and remain asymptomatic for 6 hours, the patient may be safely discharged. The patient with minimal gastrointestinal symptoms only, but an otherwise normal physical examination should be have abdominal radiograph and arterial blood glass electrolyte. If there is no pills visible on the abdominal radiograph and there is no evidence of metabolic acidosis after several hours, the patient is unlikely to develop the systemic toxicity. A serum iron level less than 500 microgram per dl would support identifying this as the low-risk patient. This patient may be admitted to the hospital for observation or discharged from home, discharged to the home with the close follow-up. Then any patient with more than mild gastrointestinal symptoms or with the evidence of altered mental status, shock, or acidosis should receive chelation therapy and should be admitted to the hospital. Patient with severe toxicity may require intensive care therapy. If the hospital has limited pediatric critical care facilities or does not have access to toxicology consultation, plans to transfer the patient to tertiary care hospital should be made early and before the patient becomes unstable for the transfer. Then management in the pregnant patient. Desferoxime is reported to be teratogenic, that is a class C teratogen. For the pregnancy, desferoxime should be administered to the pregnant woman with the signs and symptoms of significant iron poisoning. Formulations and elemental iron percentage. The ferrous fumarate, which contains 33% of elemental iron, ferrous chloride contains 28% elemental iron, ferrous sulfate contains 20% of elemental iron, ferrous lactate contains 19%, and ferrous gluconate contains 12% of elemental iron. Then ingestion of 10 to 20 mg per kg elemental iron may produce toxic effect. Children ingestion more than 20 mg per kg should be referred to the hospital. In this child, worst case scenario that 25 tablets of bottle of 80 mg elemental iron suggest to ingestion of about 27 mg per kg. This child would be expected to develop some signs of toxicity and should be referred to the hospital if at home. Then pathophysiology of iron toxicity. Corrosive effect on the gastrointestinal mucosa, which leads to the symptoms of nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, vomiting, and diarrhea. Similar toxicity due to impaired oxidative phosphorylation and mitochondrial dysfunction. The end result is the significant metabolic acidosis. Then serum iron level correlated with the clinical symptoms. If the iron level of 50 to 150 microgram per dl are considered normal, serious toxicity can develop with the iron level of 350 to 500 microgram per dl. If the level greater than 500 microgram per dl are consistently associated with the significant toxicity. Hemochromatosis, that is the iron overload. A serious chronic condition that develops when the body absorbs too much iron over many years and the excess iron buildup in the organ tissue. For example, heart tissue and liver tissue. It occurs as the result of gene mutation that causes the body to absorb more than the healthy amount of the iron. Iron overload less than occurs as a complication of other blood disorder, chronic transfusion therapy, chronic hepatitis, or excessive iron ingestion. Iron overload is dangerous because it can lead to hemochromatosis, a disease characterized by fatigue, weakness, joint pain, abdominal pain, or organ damage. It can eventually become the serious health problem. The key to preventing hemochromatosis is early diagnosis and treatment. Simple blood test can measure the iron level within the patient's body. If the hemochromatosis is not treated, it can lead to these conditions like liver cancer, heart disease, impotence in men, infertility and premature menopause for women, diabetes, arthritis, cirrhosis of liver and lungs. Hemochromatosis is the disease that causes as the result of significant iron overload. It can lead to genetic or non-genetic causes. When the disease is genetic, it is called as hereditary hemochromatosis. Early symptoms of hemochromatosis are fatigue, weakness, weight loss, joint pain, or abdominal pain. Usually, symptoms begin during middle age. Treatment of hemochromatosis. Hemochromatosis can be treated by phlebotomy. It is the same procedure that is used when you donate blood. It is safe, simple, and effective. Frequency depends on how much iron has built up in the patient's body. Most people have them once or twice a week. Phlebotomies will be for the rest of the patient's life. Side effect of phlebotomy: feel tired afterward and like to rest for an hour or so. It's a good idea to drink liquids like water, milk, or fruit juices after and before the phlebotomy. Without phlebotomies, hemochromatosis can cause it. Treatment is worth the effort. The amount of iron in your body is too high. You need to be phlebotomized. Here in each week for the year or more, pint or two of blood is removed. During this time, the amount of iron in your body will be decreased. The amount of iron eventually returns to the normal. And in the time, your iron level will be rise again. A regularly scheduled phlebotomy program will keep the normal level. Then from today's lecture, what we need to know is diagnostic evaluation of iron toxicity. For all patients with systemic symptoms, those who have ingested more than 40 mg per kg of elemental iron and those for whom the amount of elemental iron ingested is unknown. Serum iron concentration measures the serum iron concentration within 4 to 6 hours after ingestion. It is 8 hours for extended release tablets. Arterial and venous pH. Abdominal radiograph looking for radioactives. Other initial lab investigation include electrolyte, BVN, creatinine, glucose, liver function test, prothrombin, partial thrombopoietin time, CBC with differential blood count, total and cross match. Then the clinical features. It includes first of all gastrointestinal phase, which ends up to 30 minutes to 6 hours. It includes symptoms like abdominal pain, vomiting, diarrhea, hematemesis, melena, lethargy, shock from the capillary leak and the stirred phase, also the metabolic acidosis. Then the latent phase, which is about 6 to 24 hours. Where the improvement of gastrointestinal symptoms may have poor perfusion, tachycardia, and tachypnea. Then a shock and metabolic acidosis, which is for 4 hours to 4 days, which includes the symptoms of hypovolemic, distributive, or cardiogenic shock with profound metabolic acidosis, coagulopathy, renal insufficiency, or failure, pulmonary dysfunction or failure, central nervous system dysfunction. Then hepatotoxicity, which will within 2 hours, the symptoms of coma, coagulopathy, jaundice, and severity is dose dependent. Then bowel obstruction, which is for about 2 to 4 weeks and includes the symptoms of vomiting, dehydration, abdominal pain, usually gastric outlet obstruction. What is the management? Here, the secure airway and breathing for the patient is a toxicity. Also, the treat volume depletion aggressively with the isotonic infusion. Whole bowel irrigation for all patients with a significant number of pills in the stomach and small intestine on the radiograph. Desferrioxime continuous IV infusion can cause hypotension. Begins at the 15 mg per kg per hour, may increase to 35 mg per kg per hour during the first 24 hours for severe cases. A toxicologist and or regional poison control center should be consulted to determine the optimal dose of desferrioxime and during the therapy. Treat the following circumstances. Fever symptoms. Here the altered mental status, hemodynamic instability, persistent vomiting, diarrhea, also the anion gap metabolic acidosis, also serum iron concentration more than 500 microgram per dl, significant number of pills in the X-ray, which are treated accordingly. Thank you, student. Today we are completed the iron toxicity. In next lecture we will done the another toxicity. Thank you.